Good morning and good afternoon, everyone, depending on where you are in the country. I'm Michael Hay, Manager of Environment for the Town of Banff. And today I'll be talking about our hybrid bus project. And I think more than anything else, its legacy as well, which is a very rich legacy. I work quite closely with the Bow Valley Regional Transit Service Commission, or Rome Transit. So hopefully I can give you some interesting information. The Town of Banff, since its founding in 1885, has really been about people. It's a place for people to come and see. And though the park does protect a vast wilderness, it is really the Town of Banff that forms the central experience for the 4 million visitors to come here every year. And that number is increasing. Only in the last 7 years, we've seen a 30% increase in visitation. The pandemic has given us some time to catch our breath, but all of these people do present challenges for the town and for the park overall. And the big challenge here is just the number of people. So Banff is a very, very busy place, especially during the summer and on the weekends. We have really crowded sidewalks, busy trails, and overflowing campsites. And there are certainly a lot of people in the park, but that's a good thing. These people bring business and economic strength to the park. What they do bring, though, that we don't want is a lot of cars. So these are some webcam images from around the town site and the park. Cars bring wildlife collisions, more pollution, more congestion, which ruins the visitor experience, and it makes it harder for locals to get around. And building all these parking lots creates a lot of environmental damage as well. So back in 1991, when we were already starting to see these problems, the town started up a pilot bus project with some old creaky diesel buses. They were noisy, they were a bit dirty, there was no real sense of occasion, and they had some accessibility issues as well. Also, they're not very clean. So, you know, this is just a photo of an oil slick on one of our bus stops. This isn't really what we want. This isn't really the message we want to send to visitors and residents. This isn't okay in a national park. And obviously it's polluting to stormwater as well. The Bow River runs right through town. These buses also weren't really healthy. We want visitors to be breathing fresh mountain air, not the soot from an old diesel bus. It's all about the experience in Banff. We want people to feel like they're somewhere special here. And this is not really what we want them to see. So in 2007, council decided to replace those old diesel buses with some new, much cleaner diesel buses. Technology had advanced quite a bit, but eventually decided also to go a step further and go to these new biodiesel and electric hybrid buses. And these were 60% more expensive than standard diesel buses, but FCM helped us out with some funding. And we felt that it was worth it because these buses have a variety of really interesting features in addition to their hybrid drive. The diesel engine itself has much lower emissions. The buses are wheelchair accessible. And of course, we have bike racks and a beautiful wildlife wrap around every single one of these buses. Every bus has a unique wildlife wrap. So the one you're seeing here is grizzly bears, but pick an animal in the park and there's probably a bus that has that on it. These are also Canadian made buses, so it's a good national success story. At the same time, we took ownership of the transit operation, which we were previously outsourcing, and we rebranded it as Rome Transit, which is still the branding today. The idea here is that when you're in Banff, you want to roam around kind of like the wildlife do. Maybe a bit of a tongue-in-cheek when in Rome joke there as well. And the third big thing we did back in 2008, 2009 was we built a new transit facility to support these buses. This is a LEED certified facility. It's very energy efficient, lots of water conservation measures, and plenty of room to grow. Lots of beautiful pictures in this story as well. What actually happened here, though, is we saw a great increase in ridership in the years following this. Part of this is due to the rebranding and the much more pleasant buses, but we also added a bunch of additional routes. So when you add new routes, those routes actually help the existing routes by creating, by drawing in more people from a larger area. And to support all of this, we've had to grow the fleet. And this is the really impressive slide here. From 4 buses in 2008, we've increased to 30 buses by the end of this year, which is an amazing amount of growth for for such a small community in the mountains. So we have all kinds of buses now. We have night buses. We have big highway coaches going to other communities like Lake Louise and Canmore. We have night buses, long buses, short buses, and really, really short buses. And they're all very, very pretty buses. And again, they all have this lovely wildlife wrap. So it's a variety experience, but also a very interesting experience. Right now, we're really, really excited about three new electric buses, our first zero emissions buses that are coming to town. And I'm really happy to announce that they're actually arriving tonight. So this is an auspicious day to be giving this presentation. These buses were supposed to arrive yesterday, but they were held up with a snowstorm on the prairies, and they will arrive tonight. And those buses will be housed in our brand new Rome Transit Garage. And only 12 years after the first transit garage, we now have a second, much larger facility to house 32 buses with, again, more room to expand. This isn't just a plain old garage. It's actually a symbol and a Kickstarter for a lot of great initiatives. We have our first district heating system in the town site is heating this building. That district heating system is powered with wood chips that we derive from waste. And there's a very large solar array on the roof. And that solar array will charge those electric buses. And, you know, just to take this to the next level, Rome Transit is expanding so rapidly that it is actually starting to fill in the gap for Greyhound, who left Western Canada a few years ago. And now Rome Transit is operating an intercity service going all the way from Calgary. So a lot of exciting growth over the last few years. If I had to give three takeaways, it would be number one, you have to invest in people when you're doing a project like this. Don't skip on payroll. Innovation comes from people. Transit isn't just about moving people. You have to explore those synergies with other goals like waste reduction. And the last one is just be bold and dream big. So that's all. Thanks very much.